Hello YouTube, welcome to my channel. That was of course Django Reinhardt playing. In this video I will show you 5 techniques that I've noticed he is using, and these are only scratching the surface of Django's playing, but this came to my mind when I got the idea to make this video. Okay, let's start. Technique number 1. Chromatic tremolo slides. Okay, let's watch Django perform this, because there's actually a video where he does it. He also uses this technique in various other solos. Basically, I think he's doing a tremolo with his right hand, and then he's sliding his finger across the fretboard. It helps if you take like target note where you are going, for example if you are going to E. You can do this on any string. You can go up, you can go down, you can do very long. You can do very short. You can also use chords as he did it in minor string. You can do it with octaves. You can do it with any interval. Just be creative with it. Technique number 2 is rhythmic chordstops, as you heard in previous example of Django playing with Duke Ellington. Let's hear some other clips of Django using this technique. Start playing with this technique. Pick any chord form that has a sound that you like and start playing it percussively, almost like a drummer playing a drum fill. Good place to start is to use the 4 upper strings of the guitar. Chord forms to start experimenting with are minor 6, major 6-9, and diminished 7 chords. You can move this up and down, and you can change the chord during the movement to create chord melodies. At first, I suggest you keep it really simple to get a hang of it and focus on the rhythm. Technique number 3, sliding away single notes. This is a bit more subtle technique than the previous ones, but it's really effective. It brings lots of liveliness to Django's playing. Let's listen to these examples and try to hear the notes that are sliding. You do this effect after you play a note, you simply slide your hand. Usually it's more effective to slide upwards, and this is mostly how Django is doing it. You can also slide downwards. Try experimenting. You can build lines fully based on this idea, where you like use this effect on every note. Or you can do it like I think Django mostly does it, is that he like highlights some notes with this special effects to make them more exciting and give the lines more energy. Technique number four is bending. One of the things we guitarists love to do is bend the strings of the instrument. Django was not exception of this. Just listen to these examples. If you want to play A with bend, you start from A flat. Know where you are going. With this kind of guitar, it's hard to bend more than a half step, at least for me. So that's usually what I try to do when I'm bending. Technique number five, octaves. This technique is widely used by almost every jazz guitar player. But I think Django was one of the first to use it. Let's listen. I think octaves are most easy to play on two lower strings. This is the easiest grip for octaves. On higher strings, you use this grip or with pinky. There are also two other grips like this. Or on lower strings, like this. When I'm playing octaves, I like to think them as single lines. I'm just locking my hands to the shape of octaves. At the lower strings, I think the lowest note. the higher strings, I look at the higher note. And then just play lines like you would with single note. Octaves are a great technique to build up more excitement during the end of your solo. Oftentimes you can hear Django using octaves just before Crapelli jumps in with his violin solo. And here we have it. 5 Django Reinhardt techniques that you should check out. If you like this video and would like to see more these kind of things, head to my channel. There's more coming. This was actually my first this lesson kinda thing. Maybe leave a like, even subscribe. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day.